Exclamation, everybody, and welcome back to Orwell. Episode 4 was just released, so we're going to dig into it. To recap what happened in Episode 3, we went and dug into the life of Nina Matronova, a former military person, who military mechanic, who was dishonorably discharged due to going AWOL and spent a little bit of time in a military prison. And based on information we gave, she was shot. She was shot trying to escape from the clutches of our agents. Unfortunately, she is not the mad bomber. There was a commenter had mentioned as we were, in the comments of that video, that there was a little bit of a disconnect between where, you know, when the flood happened in 2016 and when she was in the military. She was in the military in 2011. She left. So when I was making the choice between was she in that one area or was she in the other area, I didn't notice the difference in dates and times. So it's entirely possible. My initial theory was that she was, they were both, her and her husband, who was dead, were both in the same troop, in the same, battalion, but they were on separate missions at the same time. And when he got killed, they were apart. But it could also be, since there isn't a whole lot of information, it could have also been more of a, they both were on the minesweeping project, and perhaps she triggered a mine and he jumped on it and to protect her, and she, he died in the explosion, and she only got a shrapnel wound in her leg, which would explain the wound that she has in her leg. I figured, if she was working on a flood, a natural disaster thing, she could also get that from there too. But it does seem to be a little bit more plausible that perhaps that was the case, that she got the shrapnel wound there from a mine going off. So in either case, it's a pretty tragic story on that side. We had this hacker called Initiate popping his head in here and there doing some things. And we do have permission to look into his or her past, although I feel like that's another red herring there. And then we got a bombshell dropped on us from Abraham Goldfels, who basically had a confession note, and he emailed it to the now deceased Nina. And I'm calling balls on that one. I'm saying that one's probably a hoax of some sort. Someone's trying to set up Goldfels for that, I would imagine. And my prime suspect would be Harrison O'Donnell, because even though he's putting up this veneer of I am towing the company line, towing the government line, in his private life he's completely opposite, and he's, screw the government, do this, do that. And he seems like he's got the kind of personality, at least from what we've read and what we've dug up about him, that would be the type that would try something like this. But we can't pin him at the third bombing location, only two of them. So it's a little bit iffy here and there as to what's going on. I think that there was a mention earlier that he was the one who archived all the web pages on their group's website, and that he had taken over those duties from Abraham, which leads me to believe that he also had the password for Abraham's other things, maybe his email account and stuff, and that maybe Harrison sent the email out pretending to be Abraham in order to implicate Nina, possibly. Because we have this initiate around, this hacker guy or person, who is trying to follow us and at the same time is following this whole group. So it's entirely possible that he tipped off Harrison that I was looking at Nina's background, and that's what generated the whole thing. Not entirely sure. We're going to find out very shortly here. And then Juliet just had like a brief appearance in there. Nina and Juliet apparently were on very good talking terms, and she turned to Nina for some help to get away from the police, and that's where we are. So, without further ado, now that I've talked for about 5 minutes with this one screen on, let's go to the next day. Episode 4, Memory Hole. I got plenty of those. Oh, back again, I still can't believe what happened yesterday. We got the perpetrator of the bombings. Everything looks that way. But at what cost? I mean, did we do the right thing? Flagging Ms. Matronova as dangerous? Did we kill her in the end? Yeah, we did. Ugh, I wish you could talk to me, at least this one time. Speaking into this one-way channel feels like barking at a wall endlessly. Worst of all, as you found out, Abraham Goldfell seems to have incited and planned the assaults. We need to get him today. There must be some lead on him we have overlooked. We'll keep observing all others in case and learn something new. Alright, so let's look at our reader. Bonten Police Database, this would be her death certificate probably, right? Arrest records. Nina Matronova, charged multiple homicide, arrest date April 15th, 2017. And holding facility redacted, arresting officer redacted report. When prompted to surrender, the suspect instead shouted out aggressively while producing a firearm aiming at one of the executing special agents. The suspect then opened fire, wounding Special Agent Redacted on the left shoulder. In defense, Special Agent Redacted drew his pistol and returned fire, as the situation briefing had already suggested to proceed with extreme caution. The suspect was hit in the chest twice, causing her collapse. An ambulance was called, but the paramedics were unable to resuscitate the target. Time of death was announced at the scene. Alright, so she is quite dead. Let's see, some headlines. Harrison's timeline is just lit up too. What do we got for headlines first? Alleged perpetrator of Bonten bombings dead. Investigative success in Bonten bombing case. Alleged perpetrator killed in her apartment. Explosive devices discovered. What? There were no explosive devices discovered. Ah, there's all kinds of, the spin doctors on here. Listen, I don't like the reports either. We needed to cover the fact that this happened somewhere in public. We cannot frighten people. Sometimes their truth and ours have to divert for the common good. All right, let's read this fluff piece, shall we? Bonten. The perpetrator of the recent attacks across Bonten has been identified and arrested. A special forces team stormed the flat of Nina M. yesterday evening after evidence suggested that she was the lead suspect in the case. When confronted by the special forces, Nina M. drew a firearm and fired at police. The team returned fire, killing the suspect in the process. Upon searching the apartment of the deceased, special forces discovered nearly half a dozen additional homemade explosive devices, which Nina had created with easily accessible chemicals, hardware, and military equipment. Investigative forces have indicated that the military-grade equipment belonged to Nina M. during her military service, which she was allowed to keep when she was dishonorably discharged in 2011. Whether this might pose a motive for Nina M. to commit the assault is only speculative at this time. Upon receiving the news, Secretary of Security Catherine Della... Okay, I'm just going to say Catherine D. for right now. Someone was correcting me in the comments, and I forget how they had it pronounced, so I'm just going to say Catherine D. Catherine D. showed relief. Our endeavor to find this evil individual has finally been crowned with success. I have never had any doubt about the capability of our investigative methods. This concludes a dark chapter in the history of Bonten and all of the nation, D stated. Oh boy. Yeah, they're going to be really rudely awakened when this bomber ends up freaking bombing again. And I'm not going to be able to solve it. People on party, did they restore her picture? Yeah, they did. Oops. Alright, so... Memorial missions. Nina Matronova. Is there more here that I missed? So, yeah, 2011 was her court-martial, all that stuff. Yeah, was there something else? Because these are still showing up here. Centralia is... Or Gentralia, I mean. Gentrarian Flood Aid. was, yeah, 2016. Yeah, you're right. I don't, interesting. All right, so I balls that one up. I totally picked the wrong thing. Memorial, so I guess that's everything. Okay. I don't know, they're still on there for some reason. There's probably some other hidden link I'm supposed to click on or something. Harrison's timeline, what has he done now? A new portrait. Just uploaded a brand new portrait of himself wearing black. Okay, yeah, he's definitely a media punk. Harris O'Donnell posted April 16th, 2017 at 10:05 a.m. Off to a slow start on this chilled Sunday morning. This is gonna be my day, I can fucking feel it. Oh, in case anybody does recognize the woman next to me, let me know. Just kidding, very obviously. Don't be mad at me, Marcia. Okay, so that's Marcia. Right? So, don't we have a Marcia over here? Yeah, we do. There's Marcia, so we know about her. So this is the life when you get good money from the National Corruptor. I get it now. All his friends are all up his ass here. And that's it, huh? So that's just another picture of him and Marcia. Marcia. House Club, the cash, targets. Okay, I think that's everything to be seen there. I think, and then we got something from the listener here. So let's see who's talking to whom. Harrison O'Donnell is calling Juliet. So this ought to be interesting. Ugh, yeah, O'Donnell speaking. Harrison, this is Juliet. Oh, Juliet's calling him, actually. Isn't this your office number? You're working on Sunday? Look, as much as I appreciate that I'm once again so important to you, I'm a bit in between things. Quit. Harrison, Nina is dead. Quit bullshitting me, not funny. Take a look at the TNB if you don't believe me. What the? What a... She's been associated with the Bonton bombings. I can't believe it. Nina, you stupid piece of... Why in all hell? There's more. I spoke to her yesterday. She called me. I've never heard her so scared. She said she was being tracked by someone and needed to skip town. She just wanted to let me know what was going on in case anything happened to her. Then she packed a few things and went on her way. Wait. What do you mean by tracked by someone? She suspected someone to be wiretapping her calls. She wasn't exactly willing to talk about it. I don't know for sure, but I think it could have been the police. Oh, this is fucking brilliant. How long until they discovered a connection to us, huh? They might be listening to this very call as we fucking speak about Nina. Why would they? We didn't do anything. Or did you? No, damn it, but it's becoming blatantly obvious these gov assholes are trying to set us up. The bombs were exactly where we held our protests, and those letters with the song Abe obsessed about. And now you tell me you've been in contact with Nina just yesterday? Pretty much the proof they've been waiting for. We're cooked. That's Harrison, sorry. Huh? You really believe that the government has it in for us? I thought you and the gov were best friends forever now after reading your opinion pieces. For what reason would they be after us? Why now? What did we do? Speak up against one of them? One too many times? The fuck do I know? We should seek help just in case. Help? Who's gonna help us? Joseph Langley might be worth a shot. Who? Cassandra's lawyer, don't you remember? A frickin' lawyer? What do you want him to do? Bust law enforcement? The government? He understands our situation. Abe also knew Joseph. I talked to him recently. Bah, really, Jules? They make the laws, they break the laws. We will need to speak in a language they'll understand, not in one they own. So I take it you've got a much better plan, huh? We need to get the people on our side, turn things around. Abraham knew that. Yeah, you're right, he did know that. So now you're set on miraculously achieving something that Thought spent 1.5 years attempting. This is not about Thought. This is me defending myself. Well then, what's your defense plan? There's this guy. A guy, huh? Goes by name Initiate. Might actually be a girl, who cares? Look, this hack on the Thought blog was a very elaborate hack. Our site is super safe. I'm not an amateur. That guy, girl, whatever, is skilled. Initiate mentioned having no sympathy for the gov. You're gonna trust a random hacker who targeted Thought simply because he said he doesn't like the government? Why would he first threaten us and then work with us? Leave it to me, Jules. I'll persuade Initiate with ease. Imagine the possibilities with our own hacker. Okay, you know what? Have it your way. I'll have it mine. Arguing like the good old days. Is your Utel alias still Julesicur? Might be more secure than calling each other. Yeah, it is. Let's get going. There goes my chilled Sunday morning. My mind is still spinning around what happened to poor Nina. Watch yourself, okay? What, are you worried about me, Jules? I didn't know you still... Ugh, no. Bye, Harry. Okay, so let's get that on there. Where is Juliet at? Here she is. Let's go grab this. As so. And then we've got a few other pieces here. So Abe knew Yosef. So let's put that over there. They know each other? Very well, this could be a new lead. I will request to consider Yosef Langley as a target. Yet another person in our database, because we're so convinced we're doing the right thing. Huh. We have clearance to proceed. We're going to need to know some basics on who Yosef Langley is. Remember to check old sources. Other than that, focus on hints to Abraham Goldfels. He's the center, the crux of all this. Okay, so we got Yosef there now. And then... trying to set us up. I don't know if that makes... believe... Well, I guess I could put that on there. I mean, I don't know that it does much, but we'll do it anyway. Seems to be a natural reaction. They must be setting us up because we didn't do anything for sure. I almost understand it. Almost. Okay. And... Juliet's working. Juliet's at work right now. So that's probably good information to have. Put that over there. Saturday, Sunday, she sure works a lot. But then again, so do we. Alright, so that's good news right there. Let's see what else just popped up. Subject, join forces, wise ass. Yeah, you're going to really win over this hacker this way. Harrison O'Donnell to initiate. Let's get his profile up here. Hey, wise ass. I have no idea who you are and why you suspect us of being involved in the Bonten bombings. Were these unusual circumstances, I would care less about a weirdo like you. But you just told me in your last email you know now you would now tend to another. Okay, let me try this again, because I'm messing this up left and right. Hey, wise ass, I have no idea who you are and why you suspect us of being involved in Bonten bombings. Were these usual circumstances, I wouldn't care less about a weirdo like you. But you just told me in your last email you would now tend to another. Well, have a look at the TNB. Is this the person you want it to tend to? Soon enough, you will have some serious explaining to do, and it won't be to me if you get what I mean. Lucky you, I'm not writing to continue this ridiculous battle or whatever this is. Now we've all made ourselves comfortable in the same sinking ship. I want to suggest something better than battling each other. You claim to be righteous? Then be righteous. Become a member of Thought. You said you're not on the Gov side, so why not be on ours? Alright, so he's going to try to recruit Initiate. Alright, well, let's try that. I thought Mr. O'Donnell left Thought. Now he's actively recruiting for the group. Makes his exit seem unlikely. Okay. So yeah, definitely Thought is still going on. I wonder. Anything in Insider? No, that's just Nina's thing. So we gotta check old sources. We gotta find out. Procedure closing. Okay, so we gotta find out about Yosef Langley. So let's get some stuff for him. We have his picture here. So drop that over there. And also, there are things in the listener, right? From when they were chatting. Like down here, very early on. And that would be... What else is new here? He's got an important appointment tonight. On Thursday, I'll put that there. That might be something. With some kind of whatchamadoozit, client of some sort. In this session here, I'm surprised nothing popped up on this one here. because he's been talking back and forth to her. Let's see, reader, what else do we got here? So headlines, heavy rainstorm ravages Bonton and Farview. Let's see, exclusive interview with Jim Founder Ronson. Who the hell is this guy? Our very own Jeffrey Paxton got the exclusive chance to interview Jim Founder Tyler Ronson after he opened his 100th fitness studio. Why? This has got me suspicious here for a second. I don't know why, but it does. Oh, it's just a back and forth, like an interview thing. It's not a metaphor. Glass table. What does Jim stand for anyway? I think you never actually told anyone. Will you tell our readers? It stands for Jim. It's all capitals because I thought it would look like it had more energy that way. Okay. Well, there's a marketer in training. These are still showing up here. And I'm wondering if he worked as a lawyer for the military, like trying to get her, putting her in the brig or stockade or whatever they call it. Kind of wondering, but I don't know. Don't know where. That's Memorial News. Cyber protection experts want it. The freedom of the nation is not only threatened by conventional weaponry and terrorism, a growing number of foreign hackers try to intrude corporate and public networks to steal confidential information or sabotage facilities in order to get advantages in a highly competitive global economy. The Army of the Nation is on the brink of founding a new cyber task force to counter this new digital danger. If you're an expert in the field of information security, enlist now and become one of the pioneers to protect the nation online. General Hartman considers activation of Kerberos. The threefold terrorist attack on Bonton has led General Hartman to openly consider a temporary activation of Mission Kerberos. This would mean a constant presence of military forces within the capital to safeguard public places. It may seem like an admittance that our security measures so far are not enough, but it is the option to go for if we want safety, Hartman stated in regard to the considered activation. Soon after the statement had been released, the Ministry of Security published an official notice to the Ministry of Defense, asking to withhold the activation of Kerberos for now. The notice was soon accepted by the Ministry of Defense, rendering General Hartman's consideration obsolete. Right, Kerberos is the, to forcibly enact the safety bill. It's got 2nd Infantry Reserve Battalion and 3rd Infantry Reserve Battalion, okay. Still not giving me much here. What else did we have from way back when? So we got Stellingen University. Now he is an alumnus in Stellingen University. It didn't let me pick that before though. So that's maybe where they found each other. Yeah, here we go. So he's got he's self-employed. And he graduated from Stellingen in 1992. All right, so then that opened up something else. I was going to say, I remember seeing him on this notable alumni page. There's also is there something else on there? Did I miss something? Oh, that's just a picture, okay. Yeah, I don't need to worry about the picture. We can go with what we got here. I wonder what that just unlocked. More headlines? Oh, here we go. The Law Offices of Joseph Langley. Excellent. All right, L-O-J-L. Lojal. Lojal. profile. After my release from prison, I got involved in a violent knife fight and was facing a jail term for parole violation. Yosef submitted a plea for mitigation, which was granted. Now I'll just spend 6 months in community service, then I'll be a free man again. Great. Okay. Sure. Profile, meet Mr. Joseph Langley, your reliable partner in law. Joseph Langley studied criminal law at Stellaget University in Bonton. Instantly after his graduation in 1992, he partnered with Catherine D., a fellow student who is now officiating as Secretary of Security in the government, to found a criminal law office of their own. Ooh, D&L Legal. Ooh, maybe it is a government thing after all. I'm wondering. Wow, I didn't even know she had a law career going before she actively joined politics. Mr. Langley definitely has been around. So far, so good on Mr. Langley's background. Excluding the connection to D, everything seems unsurprising. What we need to know right now are his connections to Abraham Goldfells and possibly to the other members of Thought. Well, I think we can figure that one out pretty easily, but... He spent a year abroad in Argentina, military service in the Army of the Nation, 1983. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Is any combat experience? I don't know if this is... Does this make any difference? I'll probably get chastised for that. Okay, so... That said, he's got some military service, which means I should be able to find him on the Army of Nation website, you would think, right? Unless it doesn't go back that far. Or I haven't unlocked the thing that I needed to unlock. I wonder if it's 1983, they said? I'm guessing I'm not going to see them here. Yeah, probably not. It's gotta be unlocked first. Let's see what else we got. Profile. I think we're good with the portrait that we have. So I can get rid of that. And then the welcome page. We still have expertise to look at. So let's look at that. My wife made a complaint about me being abusive, and I got charged with assault and battery for it. I turned to Joseph Langley, who successfully impeached her credibility. The scales of justice tipped in my favor, thanks to this man. Okay, he's got a lot of experience, apparently. We have experience you can rely on. Areas of engagement. Joseph Langley knows how to handle cases of various complexity. In his many years as a justice advocate, he has gained invaluable skills in widespread area of the law. He engages in cases of the following areas: assault, violent crimes, domestic violence, drug possession, gun possession, driving under the influence, corruption, contract violations, forgery and fraud, identity theft, copyright infringements, parole and probation violations. Significant cases. Joseph Langley's track record include the Lion Share scandal, which received nationwide media coverage in 2010. In that case, he defended construction entrepreneur Elwood Hendricks. Why does that name sound familiar? There was a Hendricks around here, who had taken on a governmental contract for highway construction. When it became apparent his road pavement was of inferior quality than paid for, Hendricks' firm became subject to corruption investigations. Joseph Langley took on the defense of Hendricks, during which he was able to convincingly argue that Hendricks had actually acted on behalf of the Secretary of Transportation, Greenway, who had taken the largest part of the money put aside in the fraudulent process. The case ended with a minor sentence for Hendricks, whereas Greenway had to step down and was sentenced to imprisonment. Okay. So, Elwood Hendricks. Oh, that name is familiar. Yeah, I remember perfectly well. No way anybody missed that case at the time. That was either courageous or dumb. Seemingly, it turned out to be the former for some time. Now it might be the latter. Yeah, Elwood Hendricks. Isn't Hendricks? Hendricks. That name, I've seen that. Here we go. Elwood Hendricks. We know that they're connected. Because it was his former lawyer, but that's all we know about him. Interesting, I say. All right, so that's the expertise thing, and then contact. My son was charged for reportedly having dealt drugs at his school. Joseph Langley was able to convince the jury that this was all a big misunderstanding. Jeffrey's now a carefree boy again. Mr. Langley truly is a tower of strength when it comes to criminal law. Okay, so we have a number here, work phone. That, so we can tap that. And we have an email that we can tap. Let's grab that. And also, we've got an address for his office. Cool. Alright, so now the listener has popped up with some things. Oh, we got a mail and a chat. We're all chatting to each other. So Juliet is he chatting with Juliet, or is she chatting with Yosef. Oh no. Well, she's chatting with Yosef, apparently. Hello, am I talking to Yosef Langley? Hello there. Yes, you are. And who would you be? I'm Juliet, Cassandra's friend, who spoke a couple of days ago. Yes, of course. Hey, Juliet, how can I help you? Honestly, I don't quite know where to start. By the way, I heard from Cassandra. I'm sorry I didn't get back to you yet. Really? That's good. Where is she? It's not so good. She got arrested. What? Why? As we wait and wait, I was informed Cassandra has been taken into custody. Apparently, they have new evidence regarding the attack on that officer. I tried to call immediately, but they claim she didn't want to talk to me. That's their official statement. Where did they suddenly dig up new evidence from? Well, that would be me. Come on, type faster, Yosef. We got bills to pay here. I have no idea, but I've just had it with their shenanigans. It's just so annoying that I cannot talk to her. I've been trying every precedent I know to get in contact with her. Yosef, this sadly aligns perfectly with another incident. You've probably read the TMB today? You mean about the Bonten bombings perpetrator? Yes, the woman that died, Nina. She was a friend, and also a member of our group, Thought. Oh no, I'm so sorry. I had no idea. It's okay, you couldn't possibly have known. You're right, this is very troubling. Come on, type faster, dude. Type faster. Come to think of it, Abraham asked me a favor for someone called Nina once, quite some time ago. I hope it wasn't this Nina. Might well be. I doubt Abe knew many other people named Nina. What was the favor about? Oh, it was just a small thing, nothing of importance. A favor of Miss Matronova, this could be important. Follow this lead. I just spoke to Harrison, another member of our group. We agreed a police might be investigating us next. They might be on to everyone in Thought now. They might lock us up straight away. I mean, they can do that. Well, even with the safety bill in place, they still need solid indication you're at all involved in the actual bombings. Although, honestly, I'm not sure what constitutes as solid indication these days. Is there anything we could do? That you could do, maybe? Juliet, I appreciate that you have come to me. It really is worrying, and I would take this on immediately, were it not for Cassie. I made the mistake to set false priorities once. I owe Cassandra to get her out of this first. Primarily concern, yeah, okay, we'll do that. Yosef, Nina is dead. If I'd be in that situation, I would be trying to get my girlfriend out of there too, yeah, alright. Yosef, Nina is dead, she got shot. There's no telling if we're next. Oh, well, I need time to read into some more specialized codes of law again. Write some emails, see if there's a legal limbo or basically anything I can do for Cassandra. Maybe I'll come across something that might help you as well. After all, these cases seem connected. It's all I can offer. I hope you understand. I do. It's kind of a relief. Thank you. I wish I could do more. I will let you know. Okay. Bye. Goodbye, Juliet. Okay. So he is thoroughly entrenched in trying to figure out what's going on. It looks like Harrison got a reply to his wise-ass email. But before we do that, let's look at Yosef. Who is he? You just received an email, I think, called Helping Hand. Unknown person to Yosef Langley, subject Helping Hand. Hello, Yosef. I assume you know who I am. It has come to my attention that one of your clients, a certain Cassandra Watergate, is currently held in investigative custody. As far as I am informed, the both of you have some kind of liaison. While this is not of my concern, it's heartbreaking to know lovers are apart from each other. I'm in a position to change that. If you deliver incriminating material for a person named Abraham Goldfels, a member of the activist group Thought, of whom I know you have been in contact with, let me know if you're willing to assist me in this, and I will see to it Cassandra receiving a helping hand as well. A friend. What is this? What is this? Okay. Are you kidding me? Is this our hacker friend again? No, I don't think so, because this has got perfect English. So, that's something else. Urgent request. Laverne, please excuse me mailing you on a Sunday, but I have an urgent matter at hand. I'm driving to the office now, and I need to use my private notebook. Can you please unlock the ID, MAC address for our local network and server for me? Blah, blah, blah. All right, so we can gain access to his PC. Excellent. Oh, there was one thing I needed to mention. The head engineer warned me that apparently there was a glitch that caused devices we were monitoring to malfunction at times. You needn't worry, though. The issue has now been fixed. To malfunction? What the hell does that mean? Is this like Star Trek where I tap into something and their console just explodes in their face? Why is there so many exploding consoles on this bridge? I don't know. It was done by engineering. The architecture group handles that. Let's see what Harrison, before we tap into his computer, let's see what Harrison's reply got here. Troubling, very troubling. I am sorry for what happened, but answer me this one. How can I join thought when I'm already a part of it? Send me your answer, Timelines TNA Web Warrior. Okay. I don't know if I want to click on that because it's probably going to be a virus thing, but he's already a member of Thought Group. Yeah. I guess we'll... I have a feeling that that's not really... Well, I don't know. It might be true. Let's get his profile up here. He is a member already? Why didn't we find any hints at its history with Thought then? Because he's using an alias, dude. That's why. He is using an alias that we can't find. So, regarding urgent requests... Yosef, it's done. Don't work too much, Laverne. Okay. Thank you, Laverne, for giving me access to his computer. For opening up that firewall. I appreciate it. This one... Yeah, this timeline is TNA Web Warrior. I kind of don't want to click on it, but at the same time, I'm probably going to have to. It's the Timeline's website, but, you never know what you're going to get when you go look at that. Let's see. Oh, his device is offline? Really? Damn, I say. Okay. Well, then I guess we are going to look into this thing here. Okay. It's a dog portrait. Yeah, we're going to disable that. Initiate, Warrior of the Web. So he's probably an old school webmaster. Status, friend me to get express security flaw news. Points out some security flaws on timeline. I don't know if that's that important. I mean, we kind of figured that, right? As it is. But I guess we'll throw that over there. Well, that triggered something. Warrior of the Web. We can probably disable that. His birthday, June 23rd, 1912. Yeah, that's not true. It's not true at all. Place of residence, the omnipresent interwebs. Entertaining the masses. Blah, blah, blah. Let's... He likes giraffes with hats. 1234 Hot Girl 45, lazy passwords. National Bread Eating Olympics and all the memes. Great. This is gonna be painful to look at. Initiate posted on April 16, 2017 at 1:23 p.m. And so it begins. The Web Warrior hereby declares the data wars on all of you. Sarah McGill. Data wars? What's data wars? Tell apart what's right or wrong about me in here, and thou shalt be rewarded. It's a trap! From Gerben, who is apparently a rainbow cat? Rainbow? It's like Nyan Cat, but a different... It's like a papier-mâché cat. this is posted on April 15th. See what I did here? That's his little hack they did. Taking my trophy to the next copy shop to print it in large format, then hang it over my bed. Lol, you made my day. That's exactly what that bitch deserves. Really like what you're doing, my friend. Thanks, a man must serve. Initiate posted, blah, blah. Community, listen, everyone. Initiate made a little game for you. I call it Horn versus Horn, and it will be available for everyone to play soonish. Those of you who want to play it right now, drop me a line. I'll get you invited to the beta test. Horn versus horn. It's two unicorn horns. Okay, it's like some kind of unicorn fight or something. That's pretty funny. So friggin' close, damn it. This sucks. I lose at this every single time. Oh man. Are you not entertained? Yeah, that's a bad meme to have on there. I don't even. You know what? I'm just gonna bite my tongue on that one. You're cheating. No way, Jose. My game's entirely fair. You need to I2P as much as you need to improve your orthography. What? The frig? Oh, you need to learn L2P. Learn to play as much as you need to improve. Never mind. Open letter to Victor Rosen. Oh, Rosen. This is the Rosen pharmaceutical thing, right? Dear Victor, you are my idol. I really admire you and your style. You've got an awesome tech company you call your own and wear shiny snake leather boots that have probably been assembled by children in Ustavakia. So many hipsters look up to you, wanting to be just a little bit more like you. There is not much more a man could want in life. Something is bothering me, though. As the bright star of the tech world, you've got to improve your security. Look, if I used a login like VRHosen and password da-da-da, it wouldn't be a big deal. No one would give a damn. But for a luminous figure like yourself, just imagine what would happen when somebody who's nothing as benevolent as myself would find those out and post them openly, say on timelines or in any other social media platform. Embarrassing, wouldn't it be? I feel like I'm speaking Yoda here for some reason. All I demand in return is to have a chat with you personally. There's something that has been bothering me for quite some time now. Even though I got a glimpse into the Rosen Ivory Tower already, you were never available. So let's give that another try. I use a chat tool called Silent Scream. I've written that myself, which will connect to any other chat tool. So use whatever you like. My nick for Silent Scream is Roots. Of course it is. Looking forward to hearing from you. Well, that's a thing. Not that it's going to help me because I don't have Silent Scream, but we'll put that there in case it pops something up. You got a glimpse into the Rosen Tower. Was that Rosen Tech building? So let's put that in there. Of course he would have. Everyone I know who is remotely into tech or programming wants to work there. Which is quite mind-boggling to me. They actually hire a lot of interns and only very few people ever get permanent contracts. Oh, so it's Apple. Or Google, for that matter. Lol, I can imagine Rosen kicking butts with his leather boots right now. What the fuck? That for real? For real as myself? Tried the password, didn't work fake? He probably changed it as soon as possible. You ever get into that chat with you? No, no chat, no message, no nothing. Bummer. I thought so highly of him. Oh boy. Oh boy, I say. Okay. The insider has popped up, so Yosef has turned on his desktop, which is good. Let's see what he's got in pictures. Some incriminating pictures, perhaps? COP certificate. COP. COP. Not ringing any bells. Certificate of Appreciation. Okay, well, whatever. Children of Parges Foundation. Certificate of Appreciation. This certifies that Yosef Langley, LLM, is an active supporter of the Children of Parges Foundation, a charitable association dedicated to the purpose of financially and materially aiding children in a war-torn country of Parges. Let me get his thing up here. This certificate is issued to Mr. Yosef Langley's outstanding ongoing financial support of our actions over the years. We wish to express our gratitude and appreciation for him. Signed, Bruno Watergate, founder. Throw that over there. I've been skeptical about this foundation, but they have been officially approved as beneficial operation. I guess it's a good cause after all. Okay, and wed Wednesday, 1993? Or is it wed 1993? Oh, it's his wedding. Well, that's a thing. So he is married or was married. And he's hitting it on with Cassandra. Interesting. Sundown Trophy. What is this? Hobbyist fisherman. And he... Oh, is Abraham in this picture? Because it's got... I don't... What? Is Abraham in the background of this picture? Is that why it's linking the two together? I guess it is. Let me pull this over here. I don't know. Dancing in the Rain? Oh, that's him and Cassandra in the rain. Okay. Interesting. Wish I could see the whole picture. It's all cut off here. It won't let me scroll. Oh well. What else have we got? We got Sis. Browser history. Where have you been, my friend? You've been to Law Online TNA Research. Research the law, national law. And history cleared by user. Ah, he's cleared his history. We'll have to get some. I wonder if it's in the trash. If his history went in the trash. Nope, I guess not. Okay. I wonder what would happen if I drag things in the trash. I guess you can't, probably. That would be funny, though. Mails. Office. Feedback on your requests. From Karen Manilow at Advised by Manilow. Feedback on your request. Hey, Yosef, I've gone through your books for the third time this morning as you requested, and sadly, I can only confirm what I told you earlier. You may not notice it right now because it's a slow decline, but you're on your way to hit rock bottom some black day in the future if this business trend continues. Excuse me for sounding like a broken record, but these are the major issues I see. Apart from your number of clients dropping steadily, your expenses since the end of 2016, especially via the credit card of yours, went up by a whopping 218%. Any idea what the reason for that might be? Well, to get a girlfriend. That's why the credit card went up. Then there is this recurring donation that's been going on for some time. I can respect that you're helping out a friend, but you have to stop at some point. Seriously. Oh, he's donating something? He's donating to some sort of cause? Or is it more he's donating to get materials for bombs? If all of these expenses are a must, well, I would definitely agree with laying off Miss Winters, as you mentioned. Mrs. Winters. Due to the fact that your clients are dropping anyway, why have a dedicated secretary around any longer than needed? Or get her to work part-time, or find someone who will work part-time for a lower hourly rate, ideally. Cheers, Karen. His financial advisor, huh? So, Miss Winters is an employee. Let's bring that over, because that's still information, even though she's just an employee. Ugly, but not of our concern. Yeah, but, you know, you never know. But this is definitely our concern. He is financially troubled. Business isn't running so well, it seems. Too few crimes, I suppose. We must be doing something right. Maybe. Maybe. I think it's something else, honestly. Regarding our meeting, from Yang at 2 cents. Dear Mr. Yang, I would like to thank you for the business meeting. It was great to finally meet you in person. Your case truly deserves a dedicated and equally experienced lawyer. After some carefully conducted consideration, it is with the utmost regret that I have to inform you I do not have the capacities required for a case of this complexity at this time. It would not be desirable to go into this case half-heartedly. I'm sure you'll understand my decision. So he's turning down cases, but he's financially troubled? What the frig? So something's going on here, and it can't be just Cassie. There's got to be something else that's taking his time, his attention away. I mean, then again, it could be that he's married to... Well, he's still married and he's dating Cassie, but I suspect that's not quite the case. Again, thank you for your trust and effort put into your proposal. My hope is to be able to work with you on a future case when circumstances have changed. Until then, I wish you all the best with your case. Sincerely, Yosef Langley. Bank account. First bank of the nation, huh? Now, what did the guy say? Yang Dong-hoon wrote... Dear Mr. Langley, once again, I want to thank you for having been available for a meeting so spontaneously last Thursday evening. Ah, that's who he was talking to Thursday evening. Although I do not wish to rush you, you will understand that in a case like ours, time is of the essence. Therefore, I wanted to ask whether or not you have already come to a decision. The CEO of 2 Cent Corp. All right, so he is 2 cent. I just saw 2 cent earlier. Let's pull his bank account over. Yeah, I saw 2 cent earlier. On something else here. That's what it is. Missing capacities. Yeah, this is kind of weird. I gotta pull that one over. Let's see. Office. So, how about the private emails? I need to ask you for a favor. From Abraham Goldfels at Stellagen University, received 12:07 p.m. on July 12th, 2016. So that was a year ago. Well, more than a year ago in this timeline, right? I need to ask you for a favor. My dear friend Indubio, he's got an alias, doesn't he? Indubio, huh? Interesting. Ah, now we're friends. Maybe this friendship is worth investigating further then. If I may address you by that name once more, I hope this mail finds you in good health. First of all, I would like to apologize for not having been able to write you as often as I should have. I hope you don't think I avoid writing due to asking you about ongoing financial support for Nina. It wasn't that. I should not have asked in the first place, and yet here I am, asking again. There is a young woman, her name is Cassandra, who is a member of my debate club. She has undeservedly stumbled into trouble very recently and requires nothing but the best defense attorney. Of course, you immediately sprung to my mind after the wonderful job you did as counsel in my case. Without a doubt, you must have heard about the riots at Freedom Plaza 2 days ago, probably also about the injured police officer. I will not beat around the bush. Cassandra is the prime suspect for said injury, so taking on this case might bring some PR headwind with it. She claims not to have done the deed, and I am willing to believe her. Should you be willing to take on her legal defense, I would be more than grateful. I will cover any costs in full, whatever you might need. Let me know your thoughts, Abraham. So Abraham was the one who sicked Yosef on Cassandra because he was a counsel, because he had been defended by him at one point in time. So this is why they knew each other. Abraham Goldfels was his client, which raises a question. What was his case about? So he was also financially supporting Nina for some reason. You might have supported the Bonten bombings perpetrator? We have to investigate this further. Look for hints if there really was an ongoing financial support. It's a young woman, her name is Cassandra. So he was asked to defend her. That's how they met. So the circle is complete. Yep, indeed. Private. So that's all we got here on his desktop, it looks like. No hidden things. He didn't hide any porn in the font folder. People still do that, right? Or is it just me? So I think we're good on this one. What else do we have here? We've got, this is everything I uncovered on that. Okay. That's just the picture that I'm not gonna pull over. Well, actually, you know what? Well, it's in conflict. I don't want to pick it over yet. We'll have to wait on that one. Let's see. We've got a chat and an email. So, helping hand, Yosef Langley. From Yosef Langley to unknown person, helping hand. I have not been in contact with Abraham Goldfels for a long time. I cannot meet your demands. I will deliver additional information on members of the activist group Thoughts, only if you mind our agreement. Cassandra Watergate must be set free tomorrow, not a day later. What the frig? He's being blackmailed. Or something like that. I didn't expect him to give in so easily. Let's wait and see where this goes next time he talks to members of Thoughts. Yeah, so he's the one, like, throwing Thought members under the bus to try to save Cassandra, who, from some unknown person who's setting them up for some reason. That's interesting. Harrison O'Donnell, what are you chatting? Hello? Wise ass? Anyone there? Initiate. So you found your way here, Harrison. I feel like you should have like a Cobra Commander voice or something. Digging through your TL was a pain in the ass. Why didn't you just tell me you wanted to chat? When you told me what happened to Nina, I went straight on to research. I got the impression that the Gov is up to no good. Great work, Captain Obvious. This guy. I did find something you won't like a bit. And Orwell. Well, that's not good. That's not good at all. Okay, initiate. Oh no, we did everything to keep it outside the nation until we were ready for the revelation. And now, it's unfortunate people have become aware of it ahead of time. We must tread very carefully now. They will not speak so openly any longer, I fear. Great. What is Orwell? That's a good question. Seems it's a system that can put everything on the web under surveillance. What exactly do you mean by everything? Everything as in this very convo. Every call, web page, maybe PCs, whatever. You're bullshitting me. I'm not, man. I'm not. I wish I was. Let's assume for a sec you're right. How do they pull this off? Storage alone is one thing, but actively going through all of it? They outsource surveillance to people outside the nation. And? These people are supposed to collect pieces of data from websites, all kinds of communication and whatnot, and send it to the Orwell mainframe. It's safe to assume that nothing is safe anymore. How come we never heard of it? Even more importantly, how come you have? I have very good connections to some hackers outside the nation. Okay, let's do that. Pull that over. They know a thing or two about secret rebuilding for this shit without letting people in the nation know. A real hacker network, huh? Unfortunately, we can't go after people outside the nation. Don't know how exactly they pull that off, but they do. And that also explains what happened to Nina, I guess. This is so fucking crazy. Do they have no decency, no fucking respect for privacy, and for Nina? Hell, this is everything we fought against. Harrison, don't. You need to watch your tongue. I do not need to fucking watch my tongue. Please chill, man, or we will regret it. Oh, I will never again chill about this madness until this madness stops. I already got an idea, tailor-made for you. Man, if you discuss things like that here, you'll get us both locked up. Let's meet somewhere then. Yeah, and say the word and they will be there too. There must be something we can do to talk without the possibility of someone snooping around. We can't stand around doing nothing. Well, there's one thing. It's a bit risky. Okay. You are using my chat tool right now as well, aren't you? Well, if I wanted to live my life in a cage, I'd go live in a fucking zoo. This system needs to be shut down. Yeah, it's abominable, but yeah, I am. This tool has a built-in cipher. Say what? It's a custom encryption algorithm written by me. Easy to break, but off record, and that's what we need. They probably cannot break this, not right away. Gives us a couple of messages, probably. What are you waiting for? Go for it. And okay, I'll activate it now. Just remember to write quickly. And keep your fingers crossed this will work at all. Great. Now everything's encrypted. I'm getting reports of an unknown cryptography here. Orwell should be able to break the encryption in mere seconds. Yep, no, it's not breaking it at all. We have no idea what they're saying. We know Harrison said a bunch of things. Initiative said two things back. Now this. There's a pattern there. Doesn't look like there's a pattern. It looks a little bit like brain fuck, actually. It could work. I will need some time to localize the entry point, and then I'll only have seconds. One thing. What will you do with what I find there? Start a war on the government. Oh, that's not true. Man, I don't know. You talking of war and shit gives me the chills. What does this say here? You told me you don't have any love for the Gov. You were already part of thought. Now prove it. Your chance to do something with relevance to it instead of hacking people's sites for fun. Oh well, okay, fine. Time to get to work. Don't forget to send me your stuff. O'Donnell out. The National Beholder just published. Oh, best see for yourself. Okay. It's declared war towards it. Yeah, I'm not sure. Yeah, I'm not sure on that one. Your entanglements with suspicious... What? What is this? From unknown person to Harrison O'Donnell. Your entanglements with suspicious groups. Dear Mr. O'Donnell, it's been brought to our attention you have actively participated in suspicious groups in the past or present. I consider it to be necessary to elaborate how this is against the work regulations and our expectations of neutrality towards every journalist employed by a National Beholder. We hereby inform you about the immediate termination of our work contract regarding the National Opinion column and any other articles, texts, or reports, respectively, Eric Brody, Editor-in-Chief, TNB. Yeah, well, he just got his ass fired. So we'll put that over there. Ouch! Side effect of the leak, probably. I wonder what else got out to TNB. And most of all, who did this? Yeah, let's see. Is this group responsible for the bombings here? I imagine you're looking my way now, aren't you? I have absolutely no idea who leaked this info. Certainly not me. Only very few people can access the data on our back end. This doesn't exactly aid us in our investigations. Quite the opposite, probably. We need to hurry. So what happened? Is this group responsible for the Bonten bombings? Bonten bombing perpetrator Nina M. apparently was a member of an activist group called Thoughts. Are they involved in the incidents? The group Thought runs a blog in which most articles are locked for the public. It has been used for planning the assaults. Bonten. It seems that the Bonten bombings perpetrator yesterday identified as Nina M. might not have been working alone. Information leaked to us from a reliable source implies she belonged to a Bonten-based group called Thoughts. This self-proclaimed activist group seemed to be behind a number of violent demonstrations that have been held around Bonten. One of the articles on their mostly locked-up blog also quotes from Die Gedanken sind frei, the lyrics occurring in the letters spread prior to the bombings. If and how the group is indeed also involved in the bombings is left to speculation for the moment. We have already requested the administrators of the blog for an official statement, but have yet to receive any form of response. Well, okay, so that's a thing that happened. Freedom is Unfree just became free, apparently. This is the Catharsis thing again. So why is this back up here? There's another comment on there? What's all this for the web? What does this do? Thought still free. Yeah, why is this thing now a thing? Is it Catharsis again? Last log in April 2017. Cassie 92. I don't know. Don't know why this is now. Why this is now active again. 23 comments. Oh, I guess because. Oh, because it's got a bunch of comments now. So you're the guys who bombed the Freedom Memorial, huh? A hearty fuck you to you. Hope you fuckers die of cancer, you traitors. I don't get why someone would kill people to get their message through. Blah, blah, blah. Die in hell, bastards. Yeah, it's basically YouTube comments at this point. Acquired server crash incoming. Screw, blah, blah, blah. We want you out. So it's just a bunch of people just writing stuff on there. Shame. Death threatened people. Right, so that's a thing now. Now that the blog has been released, there are people on there comment bombing it. Headlines, any other headlines here besides that heavy rainstorm? Internal case file, the government versus Abraham Goldfells. All right, here is the case file here. Let's grab his profile. Date filed April 6, 2015. Defense attorney Joseph Langley. Plaintiff, the government of the nation. Prosecuting attorney Jeffrey Warwick. Bonten District Court. Charge, the defendant is accused of breaching the terms of an employment contract with the plaintiff. The defendant had entered on March 15th, 2013. Huh. Excuse me, breaching the terms of an employment contract with the plaintiff. He breached an employment contract with the government. He was a government employee. The plaintiff's claim was granted, though a medical condition of the defendant could be proven by his physician, Dr. Daniel Lyons. The court could see no justification for the defendant's absence from work, since the defendant appears to be in a healthy condition at the time of the verdict. The court was able to recognize a breach of the terms of the employment contract, causing substantial losses for the plaintiff by the defendant. The defendant is sentenced to compensate the plaintiff by paying compensation equal to his previous salary during a six-month time span. Additionally, the defendant must reimburse any salary he might have received during his absence. Note, this case is considered highly classified. No media or public is permitted in court. No media coverage is permitted, neither prior nor post-trial. So, he was working for the government. He was working for the government, and he was absent from work for too many days, so they got him with breach of contract and kicked him out. But what the hell was he working on? He says he's a professor of media ethics. I'm wondering if this guy was worked on this Orwell system, probably. It's all circling back around here. If he worked on Orwell, then he would be able to... He would know all the algorithms, and he would be able to skirt by and try to drop off the net, as it were. So that's interesting. So let's do that. Bring that over. One related document. Abraham Goldfels worked for the government. Are you positive? This is a true surprise to me. I've never heard his name here. Never. Someone must know him if that is true. Why was he sued over breach of contract? Well, because... Oh, now it's unlocked. Because he was absent from work. This seems to explain a lot. He felt too sick for work, tried to get out, was charged for it instead, and found guilty. Considering the facts, the bombings are starting to look like a very weird kind of vendetta to me. High time we find Abraham Goldfels. Yeah, I don't know that it's a vendetta per se. I just get the feeling like he worked on this system or something. And they're trying to, like, pin this stuff on him because he's out and about or something like that. I don't know. Sundown Fishing Club. Oh, this is because I put that picture over there? Sundown Fishing Club. All right. Welcome, friend, to the sport of fishing. Had a tough and stressful day at the office? Your boss doesn't value your work? Documents are piling up on your desk? We've all been there, buddy. That's why we founded the Sundown Fishing Club, a club dedicated to men who deserve to cool off after a hard day's work. We're not only into fishing, even as the name suggests that. We barbecue regularly, play cards or other games, and have a good time in general. The Sundowners get together every Tuesday and Thursday starting at 7 p.m. at the Severa Lake right between Bonton and Farview. If you're interested, come meet us at the Lakeview Lodge on the south side. You may join a club at a very low monthly fee of $25. Come for the lakeside, but stay for the pint at the Sundown Fishing Club. Rules: fish responsibly, mind the environment, members only. Don't forget to present your trophies and contact information. All right, what's the gallery? Okay, there's the one picture we saw already. And there's another guy that looks really happy with catching a bunch of fish. What is this? And why is it... Is that Abraham? That's Abraham Goldfels. He's playing chess? Okay, that's interesting. Let's pull that over just for the sake of argument. And... That's that. Okay. I declare this year's season closed. Comment by Kingfisher. That's our Dan right there. He takes double the loot. Greedy Dan, greedy. I take it that violates the quota, doesn't it? I am the quota. Well, even a broken clock is right twice a day, as they say. This has nothing, absolutely nothing to do with chance. Listen, you could occasionally learn a thing, or, like in this case, two. Guy's just trying to rub it in everybody's faces here. First Bank of the Nation, Joseph Langley. Let's see where he's been transferring his money, huh? Recurring donation of $1,000. Which is probably for that one charity. So that's probably a red herring. But, what is this? So, invoice client banning, $510. Maples office supplies, invoice private deduction salary. Okay, he took a salary of $6,250 for the month, I assume? Which is pretty darn high. I mean, this guy is living high on the hog here. Salary payment for Laverne's getting half. like almost half of his salary. So that's a thing. First Bank of the Nation interests. Oh, he's got an interest bearing account. Well, look at this Richie rich man. Office rent, $1,292. Sundowner premium membership fee, $100. National Attorney Association, yeah, that sounds about right. Invoice, that recurring donation is the only thing we see on there. He's got about $57,000 in the bank, though. Grapes Finest Best Wines. Here's the credit card payment that Cassandra put on his thing. And for $400, man, she's got some freaking expensive taste. No wonder he's going bankrupt. All right, so we'll bring the recurring donation over. I don't know that it doesn't really tell you anything, though. It doesn't say where the donation was going. Just that he was making a recurring donation. I mean, I think it was just going to that one majigger that he had that, where the hell is he at? Where'd you go? There you are. It was probably going to that charity that he got the thing for. So, do that. Aha! So there might be something to the connection between Joseph and Nina after all. If you can find one last indication that this might be meant for Nina, that would be enough for investigative custody. Yeah, I don't think it's for Nina. I think it's for that other thing that we saw earlier. Gallery? Why does it keep telling me there's more things in the gallery? What else is in the gallery? Nothing else in the gallery. Why is everybody so concerned? Oh, I guess, are the comments changing for each, Oh yeah, the comments change for each thing. Welcome Abe. Club for Men, we just let about anybody. What? He has been around for some time as a temporary member. Now he has made the best decision of his life to join us. Please welcome to the club, Abraham. Welcome, Abe. Didn't ask last time. May I call you Abe? Welcome. Saw you around the last time. Sadly, don't have the chance to talk to you. We'll do next time. What? Are you kidding me? I thought we were a club for men. We just let about anyone in now? Is there any problem with Abe, Ron? You bet your ass there is, Dan. We never had a fag in the club, and I prefer it to stay that way. Wow. Wow. Bullshit. I talked to him all evening last Tuesday. Abe seemed perfectly normal. Why do you think this should matter? Hell yes, Norman. Fred told me he was practically asked out by him once. Proof enough that Abraham is gay, in my opinion. This is not of relevance, Dan. This is a men's club. Isn't it blatantly obvious that what he's trying to do here? He didn't even tell us right away. The secrecy is disgusting. What? The frig? Well, I'm gonna reserve my judgment on that. I think somebody's bullshitting somebody here, but we'll see. Would you all please show some decency? Blah blah blah. Now I get why your wife Barbara divorced you, Jos. It all makes sense. You like other men a little too much. What? Who? Who? What? So. Oh, here's Indubio. Joel, please show some decency. You're discussing a man's sexuality in a public online photo gallery. Not only is that irrelevant to begin with, it also does not belong here. This is kickbait, isn't it, Dan? So, Indubio jumped to his defense. But that would mean Joseph is like got a wife and a girlfriend and a husband? Something's... So his wife, Barbara, divorced him. So Barbara Langley is his ex-wife. That was the one that we saw the picture of, the wedding photo of. So that's why I should probably pull this one over, right? This conflict is with that JPEG that we saw. So he's definitely divorced. I would think, because he's seeing Cassandra, so that's what I'm going to get out of it. Although, is that all we got? I think so. Yeah, let's do that. Let's pop that one over there. I don't think we should mess with Mr. Langley's private life this much. This isn't what we were after. Well, guess what, dude? It's important, because we know that he doesn't have anything else in there. And then this Abraham, I don't know, like, that sexuality thing is that important, honestly. An unexpected proposal. Abraham Goldfell, Central Medical Database. Okay, what is he? So this is Abraham. This thing here. Jumping back and forth because I'm trying to figure out what's going on. So his date of birth was July 4th, 1954. Wow, he was born on the 4th of July, huh? I was born. We'll keep it at that. I was gonna belt one out, and I was like, yeah, let's just move on. Here's his address. Apparently, Abraham's address. Well done. I'll request a team for investigation immediately. Somehow, I doubt he's around. Continue your work. I'll notify you when a team has reported back to me. Okay. Let's see. It was provided Daniel Lyons, who's getting a lot of patients, apparently. Patient has reported increasingly nagging pain in the epigastric region he experienced for several months, especially during nights, combined with a feeling he described as similar to nausea. Patient also reported decreased appetite, resulting in a loss of weight over the recent months. Patient visited due to a referral of his general practitioner to exclude carcinomas. Carcinomas, that's like a cancer, right? Like a cancerous lump or whatever. Yeah, I think that's what that is. So, examination. Sonographic localization of the upper abdomen undertaken shows a dilation of the bile duct in the head of the pancreas. CAT scan undertaken to CT undertaken to clarify infestation of lymph nodes surrounding and distant organs shows an infestation of para-aortic lymph nodes. No pathological findings on other organs. Blood sample taken to check for tumor markers. Awaiting lab report. Lab report shows tumor markers. CA19-9. Oh yeah, here it is. Diagnosis. A carcinoma tumor of the size of approximately 2.8 centimeters has been found in the head of the pancreas. So he's got pancreatic cancer. Several para-aortic lymph nodes metastases have been detected. Distant metastases on surrounding organs could not be diagnosed. So he's got terminal cancer because it's metastasized. So now it's everywhere in the system. Now once it gets into your lymph nodes, you're pretty much a walking, I'll try not to be too graphic, but basically your life is going to be shortened by quite a bit. Because you're basically terminal at that point. Unfortunately, the tumor has surpassed the state of being curatively operable due to the metastases found on the para-aortic lymph nodes. The patient has been informed about this circumstance as well as the fact that the average life expectancy is 6 to 12 months at this state of the cancer, though outliers with years to live exist, which he seemed to receive composedly. Administering a palliative chemical treatment to improve the symptoms has been strongly suggested, but has been refused by the patient. So he's refused a treatment to actually make him a little bit more comfortable. He was given 6 to 12 months on February 10th of 2015. So now it's 2017. So something is going on there, but let's pull this over. This is definitely important information. Oh, cancer? Average life expectancy is 6 to 12 months, right? That is so harsh, but it does mean this man has nothing to lose. That's true, but it also means he probably just said, screw it, I'm going to go out into the woods and just live out my days, or something like that. An unexpected proposal, entry 3. My thoughts have been interrupted by a work proposal I consider intriguing yet also disturbing. Dear reader, yesterday a most uncomfortable inquiry reached me. Out of all the possibilities the universe has to offer, this is the one I would have expected last. The government has requested me to work for them. The government. The very same government bringing forth the Danger Safety Bill, allowing to prosecute on suggestive evidence alone. I do not understand the nature of this call. They did their research as they were completely aware of my views and all of my work at Stelligan. Why would they specifically call on me then? This got me puzzled to the utmost, and I cannot seem to work out what they would need me for. All I have been told is that my work would be needed on a large-scale, groundbreaking project. Buzzwords bereft of meaning. Naturally, they would not elaborate on any questions. Naturally, I refused the contract. I have no doubt they will call again. Yours sincerely, Gulf. Yeah, okay, so he said on his blog that he refused the contract, but he actually did take it because he was put in because they called him out on breach of contract. So, yeah, okay. So then he probably left work because he had cancer. He didn't feel like doing whatever he was doing anymore. And then they got him on breach of contract. When was the breach of contract? It was, where was that at? Yusuf Langley. What does it say? In dubio. Oh, Abraham is in dubio. What? So, no, that's not right. That's not his alias. That's the other guy's alias. I wonder if I dragged that onto the wrong person. Interesting. Yeah, I don't know. So Abraham and Nina were close enough that he was trying to support her because she couldn't get any work. She was having problems with her kid. I wonder if the kid was his kid, but he seems a bit old for Nina though. I mean, 1954 and she was like in the 90s. I mean, it's like screwing your grandfather or something. That's kind of weird. I mean, it's not that it's outside the realm of possibility, but still. Refuse the contract. That is not what I saw last time, though. And it doesn't show up on his profile for some reason. Why is it not showing up on here? Since lectures. Daniel Alliance Physician. I don't know why it's not showing up on his profile, because I definitely saw things on there where he was, because of the court case. Yeah, why is the court case not showing up on here? Lawyer. Yeah, that's really weird. It's just context, right? So, physique, background, personality, background. Is it not? Yeah, been defended legally by Yusuf Langley in a case. An employment contract with the government that started on March 15, 2013. 2013. When was this blog post made? January 2013. So, and then they said he breached contract for 3 months, right? Which would be March, is when the contract would have started. That's strange. Goldfells refused at first, then took the contract after all, only to then breach it? Odd. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Hey, Goldfells, you can't be serious. Would not want to see you work for the government, Abe. Don't do that. Nothing good has ever come out of anything they've done. You do that and I'm out. Your most loyal reader. Out. Just like that. Seriously. My friend, I have no intention to work for the government, yet I wonder what might be the root of all this. Whether it's something nefarious they have in store, or whether whatever it is might be turned into something good given the right treatment. Headline's still popping up there. Oh, the gallery, and then... Yeah, I don't know. Something else on here that's... Let's look under Insider again. Text office feedback on your request. So we got this freaking... he sends money to a friend regularly. Right. But is he really sending it to his friend, or is it sending it to this certificate? Children of Pardis Foundation. Like, is that... Wish to express for outstanding ongoing financial support. It definitely says financial support. So is he giving to charity? Or is he giving it to a friend? And if he's given to charity, is he giving it to charity on a recurring basis? Or was it just a one-time thing? Well, it says ongoing financial support, so it must be an ongoing thing. So is this guy financing terrorism, or is he financing a charity? This one's a rough one. Going on for some time, I can respect that you're helping out a friend. See, this Karen Manilow, his financial advisor, thinks that he's helping out a friend. Children of Parges. Oh, wait a minute. So there's been something that's been bothering me. And it's about Nina, right? So Nina has a kid, and from the indications that we have there, the kid is actually fairly old. I mean, not like it's not like a baby. It's like maybe a couple years old or something. But her husband died, and there was no indication that she was ever pregnant, right? Like, none that we have uncovered. But she did that military thing with, wasn't that Parges that she went to? That I said that she had gone over and helped them out with the flood or whatever it was? The frick is that at? Missions. No, that was Gentria. Well, shit. So, Parges. Largest peacekeeping mission. What did this happen? When did this happen? This was a fail event known as Incident 2008. So, involved units. Mission details was solved. Test with mine clearance during Parge's peacekeeping mission. Oh wait, did I? No, okay. Mine clearance during Parge's peacekeeping. So, shit, she did do the one. I picked the wrong one for that. I put her under the other thing, I think, right? I put her under the infrastructure maintenance during the Gentrian flood aid mission, which was 2016. So I totally balls that one up. She was not there. She wasn't even in the military then. She was definitely on the Parge's peacekeeping mission, which means she was defusing mines, which means that her kid, she must have adopted that kid from Parge's, because the donation thing that Joseph Langley was given to each month was the children of Parge's, right? Where the frick is that at? Show conflict. Ongoing financial support. Yeah, so he's... So the lawyer's giving to the Children of Parges Foundation, which I bet was he was sponsoring Nina, because I bet Nina had adopted a kid. Her kid that she had was adopted from the war zone, right? Which is probably why she went AWOL in the first place, other than... also her husband getting killed. So then, if that's the case, then, Abraham Goldfels had asked Yosef to help them financially because Abraham knew Nina because she was in his lecture courses, and he wanted to help her out financially. So Yosef was financially supporting them via the Children of Parges Foundation, which probably was the thing that actually put the kid into her care in the first place, and the money was going to them to help with the child. Okay, so then it's got to be this one. This has got to be the true thing. It's got to be, because when she says in this email over here, I know that you're helping out a friend. He's helping out Abraham, who's his friend, via donating to this charitable foundation, which is helping Nina raise that child. Well, was helping her until she got her ass shot up. So, okay, yeah, this makes sense to me now. So this is, I think this is what's going on. So yes, I totally ballsed up the one before where I said she was on the other mission. She was definitely in the peacekeeping mission because the dates are correct for that. So I screwed that one up. That was a bad call on my part. Because I thought, because it said maintenance worker over there, that she was looking for maintenance jobs, but she must have been defusing mines, which also explains the wound. It was probably a shrapnel wound. All right, so all those things are coming into place now. Man, it took a long time to just kind of bring all this thing back full circle. So that means then the correct thing to do here is to pull this over, because that is where his money is going. So where is he at? He's over here. So we're gonna pull this one over. Oh, this is what the donations are for. Guess Mr. Langley's off the hook then. Yeah, I think he is. And the listener just popped up. What else is there? Something else on here? I think this is just the. No, it's something else. Listener, what do you have to say? Juliet Carrington is receiving a chat from Harrison. Hey, hey! 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 Seems the Gov just fired the first shots our way. Seems so. And? You got more to say about that? I thought they might take longer to trace it all back to Thought. I didn't expect that the TNB would openly write about it. Those TNB fuckers fired me. Yeah, we know about that. They did? So quickly? Wow, they must have really loved you. Now, there's another thing. Cass has been arrested. Her lawyer told me. What? Fuck. Just as I thought it couldn't get any worse. And? Come on, give me some damning evidence here. Yep. But it was about new evidence in the officer injury, not these bombings. Looks like some ugliness is heading our way from all sides at once. Think the police will follow this lead too? Of course, it's just a matter of time. Oh, you guys aren't going to give me anything, are you? Harrison, I'm scared. Yeah. You're totally not going to give me anything, are you? Don't be. Did your hacker say something? Oh, that's... And... Come on, type it out. This guy is crazy. Completely nuts. I don't know why I ever thought I'd ask him. Don't get your hopes up. Oh, damn. What about his lawyer you talked to? Seems like we will have use for him soon. He also says he's busy trying to get Cassandra out. That son of a bitch. Understandably so. What would you do if... whatever her name was arrested, huh? What would you do if I was? Okay, now we're getting somewhere. Yeah, I get it. No need to lecture me, Jules. But Yosef did say he might give us advice if he finds anything. Yeah, of course he will, right after he sends us his invoice. You're not fair. We gotta face it, we're on our own in this. Wait a sec. Huh? He just texted me. Give me a second. Alright, let's go see that text. Hello, Juliet. Oh, hi again. I just had a look at the news. Yeah, it's exactly what we feared. Come on. It's looking pretty harsh, yes, but I made an interesting discovery that we need to have a word about. I need to talk to you and your colleague, Harrison? Yes, I was just chatting to him. Okay. I can set up a conference call. He's eager to meet you. That would be great. Give me a moment. Okay. What are we doing here now? What? Who and when? And where? There's something going on. But I do not know where. What's going on? Oh, here we go. Wait! Nina mentioned the cops were wiretapping her calls. Said it yourself. Why not chat? I think a call is much more appropriate for legal counsel. Raises less eyebrows, and chats might be logged just as easily. We're just the average couple seeking advice, right? Couple? We need to do this. Don't speak too openly. Don't mention wiretaps, okay? I don't like this, but all right. Okay, so now they're calling. I'm just trying to figure out. I heard the clicking like something was being typed, but I couldn't find out where it was. Hello? Hey. Hey, Yosef, seems like this is working. Hello, Harrison, I presume. Yeah, and you're the law guy. Right, the law guy. Call me Yosef. All right, Yosef. I just read about your group on the TNB. I guess this isn't exactly brightening things up for you. You could say that. So Jules here has big faith in your skills. Yosef, care to elaborate on what you found out? Yes, okay. So you all know the safety bill? Yes? Yeah. All in all, it's an aggregation of paragraphs to get people behind bars much more easily and to pry on their lives if necessary. If necessary? No, they use it as a sorry excuse for spying on people all the time. Intimidate them. Yes, I understand. What's particularly dangerous about it is for you, individuals might be prosecuted by mere indication of threats to the nation. In specific situations, it will be more than enough to point at a word you said in a rage to consider you dangerous. That's enough to hold you for some time. But what's even more problematic for you is the so-called transitivity of the nation. Transitivity of indication. The what? You all form a group, an activist group. This links you with one another. Now, if there's sufficient indication that, say, Abraham Crate thought to commit crimes or even acts of terrorism, well, they have grounds to arrest you all. But we didn't do anything. How is this just... This is so freaking outrageous. They'll just twist and turn our so-called evidence until they get what they need. You'll need to be very, very careful from now on. We could do something about this, right? We need explicit evidence showing Abraham created this group to be peaceful. Prove it beyond any doubt. This is why I need to ask you about Abraham, to find out his original intentions. Well, ask away. The two of us were friends for a while, but I never got the feeling he told me a lot about what was going on in his life. He was quite reclusive. Indeed, that's what he was like, except he was when he was around thoughts. Okay. How was thought formed? He found out about me by discovering my blog, said he wanted to start a debate club. I said, fine, we had a couple of lame meetings, nothing much happened. A debate club then? That would be good. That could hardly be regarded as a terrorist cell. Yeah, but Abe was obsessed with getting his message out, make people aware what the government was doing. Okay, that could be misinterpreted. What about the protests? We went with Nina's plan for the Circle Mall, turned out to be a catastrophe. And Juliet, at what point did you join Thought? During my studies, I met Abraham online by chance. He motivated me to take his course. Okay. Then Jules took over with the planning for the other two protests. So would you say Abraham intended violence and outrage? No, Abe hated violence. He wanted us to stay peaceful at all times. That is positive. So it was an individual planning this? Did someone in particular incite this? False intentions... And bad planning causes. You, Nina, me, each and every one of us is guilty of deviating from Abe's intentions in their own way. Jules, you don't know what you're talking about. It was Nina. She neglected Abe's wishes, not us. Harrison, nobody is innocent here. Not me, not you, nobody. Ugh, I feel this isn't getting us anywhere. To make sure you won't be prosecuted as a whole group, I need to speak to Abraham. He's gone. We don't know where. We don't know how to reach him. Sadly, yes. Oh well, I will need to get back to writing some emails to get Cassandra out of this mess. Of course, I understand. Yeah. I suppose it's going to be going to benefit you too as well if Cassandra is removed from custody, so don't worry. I'll get back to you. Goodbye, Yosef, and thanks. Yeah, thanks. Don't mention it. Goodbye. User quit the session. Okay. Well, your lawyer wasn't too helpful. Come on, give him a rest. This is a complicated situation for all of us. Yeah, so what next? I suggest we meet somewhere in town and come up with a good plan. What about the old meeting place? You mean that place? Yeah, of course. Just need to do something first. Don't let me wait too long, okay? Yeah, see ya. See ya there. That meeting place, what? Place important to them. Probably be the place where they met, I would imagine. So, Juliet, where is Juliet's thing at? Let's grab this. Somewhere important to them, huh? Shame they didn't say. But arresting either of them is out of the question at this time anyway. We don't have enough evidence against them. Yeah, no, that's fine. I don't really think we want to arrest them anyway. Let's see here. So, Harrison keeps blaming Nina, which I think is why that email came down from Abraham, quote unquote. I still think that was Harrison doing stuff. But Juliet seems to put the blame on everybody, which is what I've been kind of thinking myself. I'm thinking that they all kind of did their own thing. They all took his words that started out peaceful and they twisted them all in their own way. And I think that's what happened, because they're all angry for their own reasons. Harrison's just angry because he's Harrison. Nina was angry because of her treatment in the military, I imagine, and what happened to her husband, I imagine as well. And Juliet, who knows? She's just kind of caught up in this whole thing, it seems like. So, it was Nina that neglected Abe's wishes, not us. I don't think Nina, even though Nina was a mine tech, I don't think she was blowing up places. Especially not places she was just getting work at. You know what I mean? It's like, yes, she could be doing it, but she's more interested in her son and keeping him protected and trying to make money to make ends meet. So she doesn't strike me as the bomber type. I mean, yeah, she was angry about her husband, but that's not enough. That's just not enough. Especially with everything else going on in her life. So I'm thinking this one is the real thing here. I'm not sure if I'm willing to believe that this is really contradictory to what Abraham Goldfels wanted. If so, why didn't he do anything about it? That's true. That is a true thing. Jules took over the planning the other two protests. So we pulled that over there. Our findings so far have shown that Harrison O'Donnell has been involved in the planning of Thought's protests. But since we know that Miss Matronova planned the first protest, this finding now leaves no room for him. Did we make a mistake? Was Mr. O'Donnell not involved in the planning? I don't know. Obviously he wasn't, because Juliet took over. She met Abraham online. Mr. Goldfell seems quite the charmer, like all the people gathered around him. Yep. Oh, that triggered something. Then this obsession thing is... we're going to disable that, because that's not really a thing. And I think that's all she wrote in that long conversation. So what popped up on the reader here? Alumni headlines. Obviously, this freaking headline's still here. Campus life online. Topic: how to start repairing my notebook. What is this? By Juliet. Well, how to start repairing my notebook. Started by Juliet K on February 4th, 2016. Hey, so I got this new notebook for my studies as a Christmas present for my parents. It was working fine until last week, but after a short presentation at the Media Department Expo, the damn thing just won't turn on anymore. I think something's loose on the inside. My dad said I should just return it, but I'm determined to fix this thing myself. So come at me, clever IT guys and gals. Give me some advice so I can call myself a real DIY notebook repair expert. I took a picture of the little troublemaker so you can see which make and model I'm talking about. Can someone out there tell me where to start and what I should be looking for? Well, there's a PC number, so that's a good thing to have. So we gain access to her computer now. ASDF, have you tried turning it off and on again? Great. Very funny, haha. Anyone here to give me some real advice, pretty please? Hey, Julia K, I think your father is right. Best return a notebook. The warranty will be void if you make a mistake or open a case. We can bring it around to the IT admin's room A101. They'll take care of it. In any case, do not try to fix it yourself. Yeah, I got the concerns about the warranty, but I'm willing to take the risk. It's just that I hate to let go of an idea once I've settled on it, if you get what I mean. She's determined. That's not Roy. I mean, big deal. Big deal, she's determined. So what? This is just such a girl thing to say. Why you have to be just so stubborn? Listen to the mod. And here's Goldfells. Dear Juliet K, I hope I am allowed to speak a little off topic. Frankly, I rarely browse through this board, but I saw your posting and believe I saw you last week at the Media Department Expo. Weren't you the one who held the short presentation on ethics in online media? I found this quite captivating. I'd love to invite you to my media ethics course next semester, if it fits your schedule. Oh, and I'm sorry I can't be of much help with your notebook, but I'm very sure you'll fix it in no time. Oh, well, thanks for the kind words. Sounds interesting enough. I might just drop by. Okay, so that's how she got recruited. We have her computer now, which she still has. And, oh, Rosen, Stelligan, and Sys, and Trash. Okay, what's in the system? Still nothing. Oh, browser history. Here we go. Whoa. Orwell has lost the connection to the main server. What the frig? The frig happened there. Okay. Lost connection to Orwell's servers. This is not good. This is not good at all. Connection to the main server has been reestablished. Why isn't this working? Do you receive my message? Oh, there we go. I just had a strange kind of connection problem. It was like the mainframe had vanished. Still got some data lost between the servers in here. Seems it's all slowly going back to normal again. We had a joker who thought he could intrude our database. InfoSec says they have averted the attack. Huh. That must be the, whatchamadoozit guy. The... still always reticent. I just got... okay. I wonder why I got that. Browser history. What is in here? Rosentech internal database. Well, hello, internal database, but I can't click on you. The National Beholder headlines. Beholder... okay. The headlines, the thought overview. Right. That's still all that stuff. Whoops. Why did I lose that? Stelligan University, Bonten bombings, Harrison's timeline, law offices, Joseph Langley, the Targets albums. She's still looking at the Targets albums, huh? Or that's, yeah, she's still looking at these things. Okay, so that's a thing. Let's see if there's a, see what else is on here. Let's look at our desktop again. And we'll look in the trash first. Oh, yeah, yeah, she forgot to trash something. Greetings from Copacabana. Copacabana. So, who the hell is that? What kind of smile is that? Holy crap. Okay. So, that was a thing. not anything that I needed. But Rosen? Material for PR. From Ferbs at Rosentech. Regarding material for PR. I rest my case, you're welcome. Julia Carrington wrote, synchronous over synchronous communication. Go meet in person, always. You're the best, Barry, thanks. Barry Ferbs wrote, hey Juliet, put a USB drive with the material I asked for on her desk It's tons of documents, including technical details, yet most of the specifics have been redacted by the clients. I hope Maria is aware this stuff is so confidential that it doesn't even exist officially. No lists on who got or is supposed to get which stuff when and why. Don't get why PR needs this, but well, I won't stand in the way of Victor's grand vision of information sharing. Ask and thou shalt receive. After all, you had the key. Speaking of the devil, do me a favor and come around personally next time, okay? Even though you've just started here this month, you can for sure already guess what Victor has to say about mail exchanges in the company. Oh, interesting. Okay, very, very secretive. Started working at Rosentech in March, so that's a good information. Hey Barry, Maria asked me to get some specifics on a project with the internal codename Demiurge. That's not the first time I've heard Demiurge, is it? Seems familiar. I'll send the authorization key to access the requested info separately. Can you get her details on how it functions from a user point of view, the interface, the controls, and project milestone dates? We need the data by tomorrow, and Rami is overseas at the architect thing. The only other person who could get us that quickly could think of as you. Care to help the new PR assistant out? Alright, so Demiurge. What is Demiurge? I feel like I have heard that name before, and I don't mean from Greek mythology. Yeah, I feel like I did too. I feel like we've run across that in here. Stelligan? Your fantastic... Oh, there's an essay draft here. Regarding your fantastic course from Abraham Goldfels. My dear Juliet, you're very welcome to write me in any way you find appropriate. Frankly, I am happy about your open and honest message. Speaking to you, I got the impression that you're a very clever young woman who is afraid to believe in herself, which is a shame because you certainly should believe in yourself. People will always find a way to be cruel, to be judgmental towards you. That doesn't mean you have to take it to heart. Let me tell you something I rarely tell to other people. I came to the nation from Gribbling, a tiny village near Stuttgart in Germany, where I still have a family. It's one of those places where everyone knows everyone, without any exceptions. My childhood and adolescence were entirely determined by the atmosphere of being watched, evaluated constantly. It was made worse by the fact that I felt I could not live up to all the expectations directed at me. I ended up trying to be who people wanted me to be. It was a maddening, abysmal stupidity, hard for everyone involved. I would never want you to make the same mistake, but it sparked my interest in what I teach, so at least there was something positive to come from it. Come to think of it, I'm part of a small group of people who are just in line with the topics you're interested in. I'm certain you would find yourself appreciated there. I'll give you more information in person in one of my courses should you continue to attend, which I certainly hope you do. Looking forward to seeing you in the course. All right, well, this is for Abraham's thing. Abraham. So put that over there. Griblinogen. Maybe. okay, so there was another thing in Stalgen. Essay draft document. Dangers of the Omnipresent Digital Information Essay by Juliet Carrington. The modern world is in a transitory state towards omnipresence of digital information. Processes, goods, even money transcend their physical form and continue their existence in the abstract form of data, mere units of information that either represent or describe the associated object. While this yields a lot of comfort, especially regarding the speed of exchange and accessibility of said processes or goods, naturally this also has a downside. In this essay, I will consider the problems that arise from the nature of the omnipresent and arguably omnipotent information. For this essay, I will focus mainly on two such problems. A, the unlimited reproduction of data, and B, the interpretation of bits of this is all crap. This isn't the point, you can do better. Well, that was definitely a draft. She was trying to write an essay up and couldn't quite bring herself to do it. She left it around too. Okay, so something be going on. Now there is that browser history with the database thing, internal database, but I can't get at it. Also can't get at the Bonten City public transportation map either. So that's unfortunate. But anyway, we did get something popping up on the reader. So we'll go take a look. Missing persons worldwide. Help to find Gunther Ahrens. What? There's always hope to be found. Hotline, free of charge. Missing loving dad and husband. What? Gunther Ahrens? Is Abraham Goldfells? What? Age at disappearance 39, age now 63. Missing since September 30th, 1993. Missing from Griblibling near Stuttgart, Germany. Personal message. My dear Gunther has been missing for several years now. One day, Gunther did not return from work. Colleagues and friends claim they have not seen him, nor have any clue where he might have gone to. We put all our hope on the new possibilities of the web to continue our search and maybe find him someday. Gunther, I have not lost confidence that you're still out there. You would never abandon us. You wouldn't. I know it. If you ever read this, please call or write. Just give us something to know what became of you. We are not mad. We will never be mad. We are just waiting for you. Your loving wife, Margaret, and daughter, Eva Ahrens. So he's definitely not gay. That's the other piece of information we didn't have. Yeah, he just abandoned his kids and stuff. Wow. That's a big wow. All right, let's bring this over then, shall we? Symes is like, what? How could I possibly miss this? I'm such an idiot. It's legitimate to change your name when immigrating, yet very few people do so. That is what Mr. Goldfells, Ahrens, must have done. Yeah, well, that's popped up a whole lot of things. And then we've got his... So his date of birth wasn't... Oh, he's been missing since 1993, so we'll pull that over. I thought that his date of birth had changed, but no, it wasn't that. He was reported missing in 1993, the year he immigrated. What did he do? Probably didn't do anything. He probably just wanted to get out of there. And he had been married to Margaret Ahrens. That's his family? Did he, like, leave them behind? Well, I don't know. I don't know. We're about to find out here. Obituaries, Bonten Week 51, 2016. Is there an obituary of him? Gunther Ahrens, there is. Added by Anonymous, July 4th, 1953. Died December 18th, 2016, which is well within that 6 to 12 months when he was supposed to die from terminal cancer. So definitely that email that we got was definitely not from him. Gunther Ahrens, age 63, passed away at his home near Bonten. Though he was friends with many, very few knew the true person behind his gentle smile. Although his achievements in life were numerous, Gunther was a person always filled with self-doubt. That is no wonder, considering the world wronged him over and over again. Yes, he had his mistakes. He wasn't innocent. Who is? Gunther always did what he thought was right. He deserved better. I'll miss you dearly, my friend. Well, that's a thing. That's really a thing, isn't it? Bring that picture over. And bring over his date of death. You're telling me we've been chasing a dead man all this time? This is downright impossible. I mean, he did write an email to Nina Matronova just yesterday, didn't he? Oh, I'm beginning to hate the fact that we can only look at points of data without knowing the full story. The truth is in there, but I just don't see it. Damn it! Screw all this! Screw Orwell! I need to think. Look at all the facts again. Just watch for a while and let me know if anything new happens, okay? So the report from the team at Abraham's address just came in. It was completely abandoned. No furniture left, nothing. Which is no longer a surprise, I guess. Yeah, well. Yeah, alright. What is going on with the listener? A gift for you. Helping hand. Okay, let's look at a gift for you. Initiate to Joseph Langley. A gift for you. Attacking Orwell worked, but not for long, and not again, not this way. I got you a gift, though. Take a look on your thoughts web server. Handle with care. Well, that's a freaking thing. I get chewed out about this, huh? This guy was behind the back-end breakdown? I should have known. That's why it was so pathetic. Jeez, dude. relax a bit. So he put something on the thought blog that we'll have to look at. But first, let's see what Yosef just got here. Regarding Helping Hand, I've changed my mind. You won't get anything from me, he just said. Okay, that was the other one. Where he's like, I might give you the names of people. And he's like, screw it, I'm not going to do that anymore. So then, which kind of sucks because now I already said that he was going to give information out. Now he's like, screw it, I'm not going to do it anymore. Let's say overview. The Orwell Project, entry number 10. Oh boy. Published by Hancock. With all the new people on our site, proper introductions are in order. Why, hello there. Where did all these people come from? Might it be due to the fact that the fucking biggest newspaper in the goddamn nation just published an article on us? Didn't think they still had an audience that large. The irony is not lost on me. We tried and tried and tried to get our message through, but whatever we did, it wasn't enough to get your attention. And now you show up on our doorstep, uninvited, yet still wanting attention. Willkommen, bienvenue, welcome. Now that you're here, let's have a small chat, shall we? I've got someone who's desperately eager to meet you all. World, meet my good friend Benjamin Costigan. Who the frick is this guy? Benjamin, meet the world. On first sight, Benjamin seems like a fine man, doesn't he? He's 32, so in his best years, lives in a cozy house, even has a pregnant fiancée named Amy Peters. Never would you guess what terrible secret he hides. See, Benjamin here is a government agent in a project they apparently call Orwell. Never heard of it? No surprise, I hadn't either. Oh, that's the guy I've been talking to, Sipes. Oh, Jesus. So they just put his name out there. Never heard of it? No surprise, I hadn't either. They don't want us to know, at least not yet. Orwell makes it mind-numbingly easy to spy on all of you, just with a few mouse clicks. Ordinary people recruited from anywhere in the world make those mouse clicks seem as if it were all just a game. Then there is Benjamin. He is the guy who received your data, has an elaborate look at it and says, this is the one we'll put in jail. This is the one's life. We're gonna fuck up. That's one hell of a job, isn't it? Now you might ask, where did this Hancock fella get this info from? The answer is from the Orwell Project itself, because the thing isn't even secure. No, I don't expect you to believe me just like that. I'd like to propose something better. Go and ask Benjamin. Oh yeah, I almost forgot that you don't know him. No problemo. Here's his address. Oh, crap. If you would kindly visit him and send him my best regards, that would be much appreciated. We'll take care of the bastards that sit on the other side of this Orwell Project, who dig through all our personal files and grin while they look at your nude photographs. Thought is your friend. We'll get them for you, promise. The thoughts must be free again, Hancock. Wait, there's nude photographs? Where? Direct me to these nude photographs. You clearly do not know what this has been so far. So this is not good. This is really not good. How do I tell him that he's been hacked? Because he's not... I am not friends with... Why am I... Where did that come from? I grant you to add more if there is any. I want to know. I need to know. Okay, now it unlocked all the things here. So we gotta pull all this. So that's kind of a... It's very, very linear in that regard. That's what's driving me nuts here. All right, pull that over. No! And you're not gonna really like this either. No, no, no! Yeah? How many more no's can I get out of him? And here's your address. How is this possible? This cannot be happening. I need to go home now. Yep. Yep, I think he did. Ran out there. I guess I might as well bring the portrait over too. While we're at it. Might as well, I guess. He's now in the system, which really sucks. And that's all that we can do. All we can do now is log off. It's like, okay, you're done. your controller is gone. Wow. Alright, so I have no idea where we're gonna go then with episode 5, because obviously Abraham is dead. So let's do our log out here and get our full thing here. All right, so we got a lot of information out of that one. A whole lot. So we need to locate Abraham Goldfels. We had indication to believe that he was involved or incited, or that he incited the Bonton bombings. To locate him, TNB suspects thought of Bonton bombings, thought perceived with hate, and an attack on the Orwell mainframe happened. We found out that Abraham Goldfels is actually called Gunther Ahrens, who left Germany in 1993. He emigrated and changed his name, and has a child and a wife back there that he just left for unknown reasons. We know about Josef Langley, how he and Gunther were friends. Josef was a lawyer that helped out Gunther during his battle with the government, because he had a government contract that he accepted and then couldn't live up to the stipulations on. Presumably after he got his terminal cancer notification, more than likely. And of course, Gunther is died in 2016, December of 2016, because of his terminal cancer. So he is no more. He's definitely not the bomber, that's for sure. Josef Langley was helping out by sending money to charity to help out Nina's kid, who was an adopted child, apparently, from what I can gather, from the Parges incident that she had participated in removing mines from, which is where she got her shrapnel wound. Of course, Nina is no more. She was killed off due to our actions in the last episode. We know about Initiate, who claims to be a member of Thought, but I don't really think he is. Toward Rosen and Technologies, who probably created Orwell, because we've heard about this Demiurge thing, which I think is probably Orwell. And that's probably what Juliet was talking about as far as the Demiurge stuff goes. And so Initiate was really getting into that a little bit. And he was able to extract personal data, and he gave that to Harrison, who then published on the Thought blog all of Syme's information, his personal information, everything else. And also Harrison, because of his association with Thought, got himself fired from the National Beholder because he was part of a group that was suspected of inciting the bombings. And Juliet is the only asterisk here. She seems like she's caught up in this whole thing. She's also working for Rosentech. We saw some mention of Demiurge, which I suspect is some kind of algorithm that Orwell is using to find stuff. And so somehow this is all kind of coming to a head as far as that Rosentech stuff goes, which I think is what they are trying to do. I think that's where everything seems to be leading. It's like Rosentech is, it seems like, you know, going back to earlier when we uncovered that Josef Langley knew the director of security, the minister of security, there's a undercurrent here that the government itself was doing this bombing, that the minister of security was doing this bombing in order to get pushed through her agendas for Orwell and other things. This was all set up, that they found this group called The Thought, which might have been the contract that, Gunther signed with the government, because we know that Gunther continued to work at the university, and he also had this contract with the government, which leads me to believe that perhaps he was prompted by the government to create this Thought organization and recruit people for it, so the government could later on go and blame them for the bombings and then get tighter restrictions on personal freedoms and all that stuff. So that seems to be the path that we're going down. We'll see if that happens to be the case next week when the final episode 5 is released. Oh, it's been a good long ride, and it's quite interesting. I'm enjoying myself quite a bit, and I hope you folks are also enjoying listening to me ramble on. I'll tell you one thing though. I just looked over at at my recording going on, and this has been over two and a quarter hours recording this. So each episode thus far has been that much longer. We start out with like an hour episode, and then it's like an hour and 20, and then it's like an hour and 45, and now we're over 2 hours. So I can't imagine what episode 5 is going to be like, but everything seems to be coming to a head, as it should be, since we're getting close to the end. So thanks so much for watching, everybody, and I will see you next time.